What's going on, dudes, boys and girls, friends and viewers, people who I do know and those I still do not. My name is Kolosalus, welcome back to another Heroes of the Storm video. Right now, as we speak, I'm probably working on Valyra video, probably like a theorycraft or something like that, kind of explaining her abilities and her talents, because her PTR just hit the PTR server as well. Her patch just hit the PTR servers. There we go. But before that happened, before I released that video, I want to release a video about an unexpected really rise in the meta, which is Arthas Manifel. Arthas has basically right after the rework, he was very, very popular, but then fell off, kind of similar to how Diablo was buffed and then fell off of the face of the earth. He was never bad in win rate as in like after the rework, but he just wasn't that popular. But now they gave him two changes, one undocumented and one documented. The documented one was basically he now has 15% physical armor, which means he takes 15% less auto attack damage, which again, against this meta, against Thrall, against Rhaegar, against Vala, against Rainer. Okay, Rainer's not that prominent anymore, but again, you know, Rhaegar, Thrall, Vala, Zul'jin, even, you know, the new hero, he's just swarming the quick match right now. He's taken less damage against them. But there was another change, which nerfed his health as well. And that's kind of goes in line with the Anubarak changes as well. But without further ado, let's take a look at the build I like to go for with Arthas now, and how I think he's actually still a very viable pick right now in Hero League, but not only, maybe even in just casual matches. Alright, boys and squirrels. find ourselves on the Cursed Hollow map. Pretty good teams, actually. We did get a healer. We do have a tank as well. Well, I'm a tank. Darr. Let's see. So again, we already have a protection against auto attack. So we want more protection. Karazim, Varian, Vala. It potentially might be good. The block potentially might be good. And it looks like we have enough damage. Yeah, so I'm gonna go for block here. I would normally go for Eternal Hunger, but we just gonna go for the brawl. I'm actually going to go with the friendly team middle because Arthas has some strong CC. He has some strong crown control, especially paired up with someone like a Kerrigan and Tyrande, even. If Kerrigan can get a nice combo here, like for example, she did not dive in there. I'm gonna activate all my abilities and maybe we can pick up a kill here, maybe. Oh my god, this is a brawl. This is a real ass brawl. Anyway, our Q ability is actually kind of like designed how I actually like it. Our Q ability is called Death Coil. Basically, I can use it either to deal damage to a chosen enemy, or I can actually... You body block. There we go. So I can use it right here, kind of like to deal damage like I did to the Zagara by clicking on the enemy, or I can click on myself and actually heal myself for a little bit of life. Pretty good. I actually like that design. You are in power of what you actually need. Let me clear up this creep because I don't like it. No. So we just use our Frozen Tempest, which is our E ability. It's basically a toggle on and off. When I toggle it on, I have a very, very strong kind of like a burning rage effect. Kind of like an AoE around me effect, which does damage and slows enemies. Later on, it's gonna have some additional functionality, but for now, all it does is basically people in it take damage and they're slowed for a little bit. We are going to go for Biting Cold here, which will increase the damage of our E ability. So what I'm going to do here, I'm going to go to Zagara. I can honestly do a lot of damage here. I'm going to actually use our Q to heal ourselves. And, well, we're not gonna get pushed out, because she is definitely super low. Oh, baby squirrel, if you're not careful, you're gonna get wrecked by the fucking Lich King. I'm the Lich King here, Zagar. Not you. So yeah, this is just gonna allow us to spread the CC love across the entirety of the enemy team. I mean, I can use it also to escape. Nice, nice, nice. Okay. So Varian kind of failed his gank attempt. Let's run our friendly team that he might be coming this way. I will be coming behind them. I should not have any chance, basically, against a Varian 1v1. Well, not any chance. I should be very careful when I'm actually taking him away from his team, which is fine. What I'm gonna do here, I'm just gonna bait him, and he's gonna die. Easy dowgy. That's a guy at the bottom. Fine, okay, our W ability, which is what I used to actually to root the enemy variant so he could not charge me. Our W is called Howling Blast, basically. It's this in this radius around us, very big radius around us, I shoot out this small radius that basically roots anybody in that circle. Also dealing some damage and rooting them for 1.25 seconds. Very, very good. Super good CC, especially when comboed with someone like a Kerrigan. Kerrigan, of course, when she lands her combo, she does get. I hope she's not going to be afraid. I'm going to rotate up here. Our Li Ming is a little bit of trouble here. Even not a little bit. She's in a lot of trouble. I mean, that's fine. Oh, I use my Ivan on fortitude here. That was actually terrible. Bad timing. Kerrigan was actually low. I think we should just give it up here. Yeah, just give it up. Well, maybe not. Although Zagar is here. Yeah, we should bail. Because he used it here to. Can we pick up some? Give us some. I mean. They're good just because they have Karazim. I'm trying my best. Gonna use it here, preserve my mana by turning off my my Tempest, and we're just gonna back up. It's fine though. So yeah, again, like here it could be a damage or a heal, root and some damage, and also slow and some damage in a little area around. It's very, very good for wave clear. I think he's one of the stronger actually laners right now, but he needs to be careful against most other heroes. Our trait is called Frostmourne Hungers. Allows me to activate my D so my next basic attack comes out instantly, and I will also be dealing 100% more damage and restoring some mana on that basic attack. On level 1 we did pick up the block, on level 4 we picked up the increased damage on our E, which allows you to just deal more damage in that area. You can see I'm not sure what's the base damage right now, so I can't really tell you, but we just have to believe the tooltip that it actually says what it actually does what it says. Enemy Vala is somewhere here. I'll try to sit in the bush. Maybe she's gonna be coming from here, because oh yes she is. She just used her escape to get into the fight. I'm gonna use my Icebound Fortitude here. I'm gonna try to root this enemy Karazim. I do not succeed in doing so. I'm gonna actually use this to sustain myself, rather. Now I'm actually in a little bit of trouble. I'll be fine though, I'll be fine. The defending team is just way too late to the objective right now. I mean, it looks like we're actually on our way to the objective, but they do still pick it up, so. Really bad. So I can actually show you here how is he just amazing at wave clearing. Of course, like he has a kind of like a mana cost to it. But honestly, what you can this is bad. But honestly, what you can do is you don't have to actually commit to it. You don't have to actually commit. I think Army of the Dead will be a little bit more value here. Because they don't have too much burst. Yeah, they don't have too much burst, so I think I'm gonna go army of the dead. Enemy team does take the bottom fort. I wasn't even paying attention, to be honest with you guys. Right, so at level 7 we'd go for Icebound Fortitude, allowing us to get this activatable ability here that we can activate. We basically for 3 seconds take less damage and also have the good old effect of the Relentless. Our Rexar does get picked off again. I think he was doing the boss actually, which is terrible, right? Let's destroy that. They try to block the skill shots if they're coming, if they're gonna come this way. They don't give a shit, they're doing the boss. Okay, I just wanted to basically make her scared. The enemy team does actually finish the boss here. I'm gonna activate my my ultimate here. I activated it too late. And now you can see I'm spawning these little guys that are just kind of running around me. And then I can also reactivate my ultimate here to heal for a very, very big amount. You know, they're just kind of like these minions that are just walking around. Ooh. This Zerato. No Zerato, this Gul'dan is out of position. I'm on my way top. We are rotating a little bit too late though. Our top fort is already gone. So yeah, it's very good, very, very good for your sustain. The other heroic summon Sandragosa has also its place, but it's mostly to disable buildings. And like honestly, on this map, it's not that much value just because the curse itself disables buildings. So you don't need a building disable unless you're going for a big push. Of course, it could be used, you know, as a team fight, but it's just not as good in the team fight as it is in kind of like a pushing scenario. See what I mean? Hopefully you do. We do actually have to contest this, so I am on my way. I'm gonna be too late, that's my bad. I mean, we were defending boss, so it's not really nobody's bad, but... Okay, the enemy Gul'dan will pick up the objective. It looks like we will be losing our Kerrigan as well in the process. Should we just bail? I mean, Zagar is there, yeah. They want that bear so much. Terrible. Misha dies. Misha should never die. They're gonna go for the other boss, which is good for us because they're losing time. They're not actually picking up the. Let me pop my Icebound Fortitude here and actually pop my zombies as well. And let's start healing. Let's start it rolling. You can see I'm fine. I was ganked, but I'm fine just because of the Icebound Fortitude, reducing my damage and also the healing that I'm getting from the Army of the Dead. And Mikara's in pushing by himself down here. He's actually out of position. If I can land like a follow-up on the Kerrigan combo, it looks like Kerrigan is not coming here, though. I'm gonna slow him down. And he's dead. Good. Let's go for Frigid Winds here, reducing the enemy attack speed by a little bit. I'm gonna walk in here like it's nobody's business. I mean, I think I can take it. I'm gonna activate my. Ooh. Ugh. So, just not enough follow up. Our Leeming is still here, clearing the wave. Our Tyrande was actually AFKing in the base. Maybe she was still dead. Okay, maybe she. Okay, let's say she was still dead. Let's give her the benefit of the doubt. The only person who came to my aid was the Rexar. That's fine. I'm not gonna blame my team for my own mistakes. That was my bad. That was 100% my bad. So what Frigid Winds will do for us on level 13, it's going to reduce the enemy attack speed again. The longer they stay, the longer it's going to be, the more it's going to be reduced by the attack speed of the enemies, which are basically affected by our Frigid Winds, not Frigid Winds, by our E ability, our Frozen Tempest. The enemy team is just sacrificing a lot for this, but they are 5 there, and we are not. I can't do this. Like, when there's all five people on me, even I can't sustain through that damage, even though they are very, very high on the auto attack damage. It still doesn't matter that I have the 15% reduced one. That's why I thought originally that he's not going to be good. He is not going to be good in the current meta, because just the 15% just is not going to do that much. But it actually does. It actually does quite a lot for him, which is actually quite good, because I like Arthas. I like his playstyle. He's kind of like early game ganker, then later kind of a utility tank, kind of, you know, clearing lanes and also just dealing damage in an area. So we are out of our ultimate, which is kind of bad. Kind of bad, I can't lie to you guys. Let's finish out this boss. Misha dies again. This guy's terrible. He keeps sacrificing Misha, and it's just for nothing. Just for nothing. Okay, let's help Kerrigan finish up this camp. I don't think we can. Now we can contest them, but it looks like the enemy team will be just picking this up with no problem. I'm gonna go for Remorseless Winter here. Basically, if the enemy team stays in my E a little bit too long, I got feared. And they will be rooted like this variant right here. I'm gonna actually follow up on my route here, and he's gonna be taken out of the fight. I'm gonna activate it right here again. I'm gonna activate also my army of death so I can heal myself. Ooh, it's gonna miss. Okay. Looks like we can pick up this, and we can actually. I wanted to boss, but this is gonna be already a curse for us. Come on, guys, let's start pushing. Let's start to push. Let's actually delete this so she doesn't have the global presence anymore. Let's get rid of her vision. And we can start pushing. Let's actually deactivate our trait right now because we don't need any AoE damage. I guess extra damage would be nice. The defending team is just wasting time right now by picking up the boss. But honestly, I guess I'm sieging. All right, let me stand in the middle. Let me actually deal some damage to both. Hopefully, I'm not gonna get picked up though. So again, it's kind of a playstyle of this early game ganker, then later on, like you're kind of a utility tank with all the damage that he's doing, all the CC that he's applying. I really, really enjoy it. The friendly Rexar is going to be, I think, taken out. Yeah, the taunt is going to secure a kill on him. Not even gonna dip down there. I mean, I was going to, but only if the friendly team wanted me to. But it looks like they were like, no, get the fuck out, man. There's no reason to die. Baby, can you close the window because it's fucking cold? Close the window then. Please. Alright, Kerrigan, there's no need to die for this fort. Well, we actually killed somebody. I don't know how, but we did kill somebody. Okay, I'm taking damage from the tower. Yeah, let's back off. We don't want to get comboed by Varian Taunt anytime soon. What me? I'm Arthas Minotaur. Horsey? Oh, the new Isaiah. That's the 30,000 gold mount right there. I'm not sure if it was worth it. The Nexus Charger is from BlizzCon 2 years ago. Not sure if it's worth the money at all. I didn't get it. I know a lot of people. I mean, it's still going to be there for a week, but I'm not going to get the money for it because I need the money for the Valera. Valera, by the way, looks like a very, very fun hero. If you ask me, let's come here and let's do what Arthas is strong at. He's strong at clearing lanes, very, very nicely applying that AoE damage. Oh, Varian's kind of split here. Varian is very split. I don't know what he was doing. Anyway, let's pick up Death's Advance. Are we going for the Death's Advance or are we going for the Anti-Magic Shell? Let's go for this Death's Advance. I feel like it might actually give me a little bit more value. We are double tanking with me and Rexar, so I'm not afraid of dying, especially with this Army of the Dead. I feel like I will have enough survivability here. The enemy team is going to start rotating right here. Ooh, that was actually good. I'm gonna activate my Death's Advance here. I'm gonna try to focus on this Varian. Now trying to focus this person, and we can actually get some pushing done. Yeah, we can get the boss. The boss is definitely a good play, I think. Let's just not give them the vision that we're doing it. And yeah, so number one tip when playing Arthas is turn off your army, your Frozen Tempest whenever you are not using it. There's no reason for you to keep it up and keep losing mana. Like there, right there, I turned it off and I'm not using it anymore. I actually could take away this vision from the enemy team. I know we lost the thing here, but we can actually, we picked up a kill on the enemy's ziggity zigzag, yeah man, which means that, no, I wasn't actually stuttering there, I honestly just tried to make fun of it, tried to make it funny, never works. We should win the game right here, come on guys, like, we should win the game. I do have my ultimate, the enemy, Gul'dan does have his ultimate. I'm gonna activate my Icebound Fortitude. I am getting a focus down. The end. Oh, the fear is going to secure killing me 100%. Yep. Fear is just super strong because I can't use anything. I cannot heal from a zombies, and nothing can be done here. Let's back off. Get objective. And looks like our Tyrande is getting picked apart here. Bavarian a little bit overstepping though. Get back. Why do you keep brawling? I don't understand. It's terrible. Just get the objective, and our boss still did a very, very respectable amount of damage to the enemy core. I usually go with a different build. I usually do. I usually go for the Cinder Ghosta here, and then Anti-Magic Shell again. The Anti-Magic Shell, I don't think it would be doing that much against this team. Maybe against the 7 side, it actually would have been very, very good, because it's ability damage. But again, I think this advance will help us at the end, just because, again, it helps us to chase more efficiently. And also what it allows us is chase while you also slow the enemies down. So I'm gonna come in here. Hopefully the friendly Kerrigan will be able to secure a combo, maybe. Okay, they're gonna kill us. I'm just gonna come in here and try to kill these minions before they do any major damage. We should be trying, we should be going for a fucking boss. Why not go for a boss? They're bossing. Oh my god, they're bossing. And our friendly Kerrigan is in a lot, is in a bad spot. I'm taking a lot of damage. I'm taking a lot of damage for no reason. I'm gonna pop my ultimate here. I'm just feared. I'm just CC'd for days. I can't do anything because of the CC. I used my Icebound Fortitude a little bit too early there. Actually, I used it to nullify a little bit of the damage from the friendly, from the enemy Karazim. But we look like we are able to turn it around. We need to be careful. The whole of the enemy team is dead. We are getting some damage on the core. Zagara is coming back really soon, but we do have this pretty sizable push here. Basically going to be pushing their core right now. Enemy Zagara coming in and trying to do some work. Our actually core is getting hit along with their core. Can we defend it? Yeah, I think we can. I think with the Tyrande Hunter's Mark, we should be able to. Maybe we just won't be able to. Can we defend? Yes, yes. I think we should be able to defend it. It's very, very close though. It's very, very close though. Basically, whoever gets the curse now wins the game, basically. We need somebody on there, like right now. She has her Nidus, when she I think she'll be able to get there much faster than we can. Somebody clean this up. Tyrande should stay. Let's let Tyrande stay. And yeah, okay, so we will be able to pick up the second objective. The next one, honestly, it actually puts us ahead, because next one should win us, should in theory win us the game. The enemy team will have to focus on the bottom lane. while we will be able to push others, or actually just maybe just win a team fight in a 4v5 scenario or something. I'm not sure what to do here. The enemy team does have a did have a visual on us. Now we do still. We should definitely keep us 5. I'm wasting my mana. That's always good to do. We should just give it up. We should just give up. We need to defend. We need to defend the camp. I think they're gonna start rotating. I think for a gank. So I'm gonna just bail out of here, boys. Let's see, the enemy team will be pushing with the camp middle, as long as we I see the demonic circle. Ooh, okay, this is going to be a team fight, boys. Sandragosa will be nice here, I think. Sandragosa will be definitely super nice. As bomb 4 digit coming down, I am taking a lot of damage from this enemy team. But looks like I just baited the enemy Karazim into walking into us. He's taking a lot of damage. I think we might be able to pick up a kill on him if I am taunted right now. I don't have any more minions. Let me pick this up. I think we did it.
Double kill. Well
done. I think we did it. Just go bottom. Just go bottom and win. Just go bottom and win the video game. Before they do. Oh, actually, they won't win the video game because they have no pushing power right now. Because of our curse. Yeah, looks like this is going to be good game. Very good game by the friendly team. Honestly, I got a little bit scared there that we would lose, but it looks like the fear will try to do something. I'm gonna use my Q to sustain myself rather than do anything else. The fear is not gonna come down. And we're just gonna win the game. Okay, I did die 4 times, which is a little bit too much, but that's only due to the fact that our healer again wasn't the best healer in the world. It wasn't Malfurion. It wasn't. I know she's the MVP, but she's a playmaker. She's not a healer that much. Malfurion is a healer. Morales is a healer. I'm a healer. Even Rhaegar is a. He's kind of a mix between a healer and a playmaker. Did good, senpai? Yeah, man. You get it from me, brother. You get it from me. So, that's just Arthas. That's how he is right now. He's a very, very similar spot to where he was basically right after the rework, which is a good spot. It's a balanced spot. It's very, very similar to how Anubarak received his additional 25% ability damage decrease. Basically, he takes 25% less damage from abilities, but on the other hand, he has less health and less health regen. But actually served him good. I think the actual change actually put his win rate up very, very high. This is actually the same case for Arthas. But after the actual nerf of his Mortal Coil, I think that's what it's called. No, it's called Embrace Death. His Q build, I don't think is that good anymore. And even just as this loses value, also the Immortal Coil healing talent does lose value as well. Just because you can heal yourself every single time with the Q, you can just use it as a self-heal. I think just Icebound Fortitude takes it over here. Even though Rune Tap was actually buffed to be 4% of the health, I think the Icebound Fortitude still takes it just because it has this very, very strong old Relentless effect that it's really going to help you. It's really going to alleviate some of your weaknesses, which is basically no disengage. Your disengage is your E. You try to slow enemies so they do not catch up to you, and then again, you're going to probably pop this to take less damage and try to escape any stuns, slows, or roots that way. I did not like this skin before, but I actually do like it now. I actually do like it a lot, and one of my favorite skins actually in the game. I used to just use this kind of like a human because I don't like this skin at all. His master skin is a joke. I gotta tell you guys, his master skin is one of the worst master skins in the entire game. But I do use this skin now. I do like it. Anyway, let's go over the build again. Arthas, level 1, We did go for block because they had a lot of auto attacks. So we have the 15% just passive decrease from the basic attacks, but now he also has a block, which, you know, which again, every 5 seconds he gets a stack basically where he can mitigate most of the damage dealt with the next basic attack he takes. The one I would go for is Eternal Hunger normally, just because, well, if they have somebody like fast attack and like Tracer or like Tychus, like a block doesn't really get too much value because they have very low damage of their basic attacks, but they do it a lot over, you know, over a certain period of time. So their block doesn't actually get too much value. So against those people, I'll probably take Eternal Hunger. Just get some more deeps out of our Force More Hungers, and also get some more mana out of our deactivation. Block is just good against Vala. It's good against Varian for the initial nullification of the burst that he does with his trait. But yeah, level 4 we did go for Biting Cold. Don't fall into the trap of getting this talent. Just learn to manage your E so you don't lose too much damage. Learn when to turn it off, or learn that you don't actually have to kill the entire minion wave with your E to actually get the full value out of it. You can just kind of make it weaker, turn it off, save the mana, maybe actually activate your D on the minion also as well to get some mana back. And just don't fall into the trap of taking this talent. It's terrible. And yeah. So I do go for Biting Cold. I like it, just increases the damage, the overall damage that you do. And you're just standing there, just being annoying to the enemy team, dealing damage, slowing them down, rooting them, and eventually also, eventually rooting them and slowing their attack speed. On level 7, we did go for Icebound Fortitude, kind of giving us a little bit more survivability. On 10, again, it's just, he has two different heroics. He has one, which is his survivability teamfighting tool. They will be dealing damage, these ghouls. They will be kind of maybe blocking skill shots for you as well. But then they will also be there for you to restore your health and just stay buff, stay healthy across it. Kind of alleviate and take some strain off of your healers. Level 13, we did go for Frigid Winds, allowing us to reduce the attack speed again. The longer the enemy stays in your Frozen Tempest, I think that's what it's called. Yep, they will be basically having slower attacks, which is awesome. Which is awesome. It was good again against Vala, against that Zagara. Zagara has a pretty hefty attack speed, attack damage. So she was actually very annoying to us. Varian, who else they have? They had, who was their healer? Karazim, another very, very good one. If he cannot attack as fast, how can he heal? You know what I mean? Or deal damage. 16, we did go for Remorseless Winter. I think it's super strong. I think it's one of the strongest talents, and people aren't just using it enough. But I think it's only super strong when you actually do go for the talents, where you go for the attack speed, because you just keep them in that constant slow. They cannot attack almost at all. And you also will be dealing more damage to them. Basically, if they stay long enough in your E, they will be rooted for a very, very hefty amount of time, 1.75 seconds. It's crazy. And if they just kind of get touched even once, they already get slowed, and you'll be able to keep onto them and eventually root them. So, a very, very good talent. It's just very, very underrated in my opinion. And this can happen once every 10 seconds, which means that you will be able to really have a lot of CC on the entirety of the enemy team every 10 seconds, which is pretty crazy. And level 20, I do believe you have few options here. Ghouls last longer and more are created. That's definitely good. They will heal you for more, they will be there for longer, plus you will actually spawn more of them, so you can heal for more potentially, but also deal more damage and have a little bit more utility by maybe, again, blocking the skill shots or maybe even dealing damage with them. Absolute Zero, I think, is a great talent. Sindragosa flies twice as far, which is good. Enemy heroes are rooted for 2 seconds, so it's not going to be a huge deal, but again, it could mean that they are hit by, I don't know, lava wave or something like that. And then they are slowed for a very, very huge amount of time. 3.5 seconds actually is a lot. 60. Not sure why. And then, okay, so it says that it roots them, and then after the root expires, then it slows them. But what I didn't actually say about Syndragosa, that what it actually does, it disables buildings. It disables buildings and also non-heroic enemies, which is pretty goddamn, which is kind of like a, kind of Syndragosa is like Sylvanas's hero power, but a little bit stronger, but on a much, much longer cooldown, because you just kind of blow it. You kind of just put it across a fort and a couple of towers and minions, and just disable everything for a very long amount of time. Whereas Sylvanas has to be there and kind of sustain his trait onto it. And level 20, again, absolute zero is fine. Depths advanced, we did pick it up to try to keep up to the enemy team. Not sure if it was a good choice. Maybe anti magic shield would have been actually better against the Gul'dan. But anti-magic shell is interesting because it will nullify 100% of the damage, of the ability damage you will take in for the next 3 seconds, and also it will heal you for the 25% of the damage taken. Not sure how well that will work, because I think the most of the time when I actually died, it wasn't from abilities, it wasn't an actual ability focus. I think it was mostly, again, this would have been good against the 7-sided. That's one thing I really do think it will be good against. But other than that, again, Gul'dan's damage is pretty slow. Vala, I guess, has a little bit of abilities, but again, most of her damage comes from her from auto attacks. But yeah, so this has been Arthas. I think he's a very, very good spot now. I do enjoy playing him myself, and hopefully I can play him more and maybe showcase him off in my streams. By the way, if you guys didn't know, I do stream almost every day. I did just stream some Diablo, but I mostly stream Heroes of the Storm and Hero League. I do try to climb a lot, and yeah, expect the Valira theory craft video next, and I'll see you guys in the next one.